Hey there, and welcome to Ignite 2021. I am Harshita Murthy, and we're going to walk you through how Surface and Endpoint Manager are working together to create a wonderful experience for enterprise customers. Hope by now you've had a chance to look at our fall lineup of devices for this year. Surfaces always push boundaries of innovation with new form factors, such as 2-in-1 with Pro, Dual Productivity with Duo, Portability with Go, and most recently Surface Laptop Studio that adapts to your natural style of interaction with the device. With all of these products, you will notice the attention to detail and how we put users first in designing these devices. We've extended this philosophy even to enterprise customers. To enrich our commercial user experiences, we have worked in close partnership across Microsoft to bring you seamless device management to IT. Today, we can't wait to share something exciting we are bringing to Endpoint Manager to delight our Surface users. More about that later. First, I'm joined by my awesome colleague, Mike Danowski, to talk about how Surface shines on Endpoint Manager.
Thanks, Harshita. Hey there, everyone. By the time you leave this session, you'll have a clear idea of how easy it is to manage your Surface devices with Endpoint Manager. Microsoft Endpoint Manager is a leader in the unified endpoint management space. To get started, let's focus on features IT admins can utilize today. Endpoint Manager provides flexibility in how IT admins can provision new devices for end users. With Autopilot, devices can be shipped directly to end users, reducing time and cost when compared to traditional provisioning methods. Since 2017, zero-touch provisioning has reduced deployment costs by 16%. To put that into perspective, that's 4 hours saved with each device deployed through Autopilot. In 2019, Surface partnered closely with the Endpoint Manager team to bring the Device Firmware Configuration Interface, or DFCI, settings into life. DFCI enables Windows to configure UEFI for Autopilot deployed devices. This capability allows an IT admin to limit an end user's control over BIOS settings. For example, an IT admin can lock down the boot options to prevent users from booting up to another OS, such as one that doesn't have the same security features. Since the IT admin has pre-registered the device in Intune, when the end user boots up the device, they're taken to the company's page. The user then enters their password and completes multi-factor authentication, or MFA, if enabled, to begin the provisioning process. There are three stages: device prep, device setup, and account setup. In these phases, the IT admin sets the policies, settings, and applications the user should receive through the Intune portal. Once the device setup is complete, the user is taken to the desktop and the device is ready to use. With Windows 11, we've made a huge user experience improvement when the user first interacts with their device. Just like that, they're ready to get to work. However, the past year has fundamentally transformed employee and customer expectations. People are working from home or working in hybrid configurations, and organizations are changing to allow flexibility with the devices end users are performing work on. This doesn't mean compromising on zero trust. End users can access the resources they need to get their work done so long as the device they're using meets the organization's compliance requirements. This is Anita's new Surface Laptop Studio she purchased for personal use and absolutely loves. But working from home, she wants to design a big presentation for her client using this device. With Endpoint Manager, Anita can use her personal device without compromising the security requirements of her company. Anita wants to check her mail on the Windows Mail app. When she tries to log in, she'll get a message saying that her device is unknown. By following these steps, Anita can enroll her device where it will be evaluated for compliance. And once a compliance check is done and enrollment is complete, Anita is ready to get rolling. From an IT administrator side, the device will show up in Endpoint Manager, and the IT admin can view the compliance state. Now that we've covered a few ways users can enroll Surface devices, I'll hand it back to Harshita to share our exciting announcement.
Thanks, Mike. We have taken a step further in the enterprise space to bring a new capability to make Surface device management easy, seamless, and simple. For customers who use Endpoint Manager and Surface, we're bringing the best of both worlds. I'm beyond thrilled to introduce to you Microsoft Surface Management Portal. This is our centralized solutions for IT admins to self-serve, manage, and monitor Surface devices at scale in Microsoft Endpoint Manager. Now, all of these features were purpose-built to reduce the IT cost. With this portal, you will reduce the cost you would incur to manage warranty and support requests for Surface devices. After research, we evaluated many options and created an experience that enables you to self-serve seamlessly. We reimagined an experience to self-serve and tailored the experience to meet your needs where you are. Surface Management Portal is available now in the All Services tab of Endpoint Manager. Now let's do a deep dive on the portal. As soon as you click on Surface Management Portal, you will be taken to monitor section of the page. With just a click of a button, you will be able to see the list of Surface devices split by model names. You will notice that the device models are arranged by descending order, enabling you to see the largest device model first. It gives quick insights into device health, enables you to view your support request and warranty. We're also bringing news about the latest and the greatest updates from Surface through news bulletins. You no longer have to look at multiple avenues to get all of this information. This one-page view is enough to give you an overview of Surface device statuses and help you make quick decisions on needed changes. You will notice that the monitor view automatically displays information on support tickets and their latest status. We've created a separate section for detailed overview of all support requests. As soon as you land on this page, you will see the number of opened and closed support tickets. If you need to view more information on these support requests, it is available to you right from the portal. In future, we will also be able to create support requests, enabling you to manage all support queries in one location. Viewing the health of your Surface devices is made easier than ever before. Information such as active and inactive devices helps you manage your inventory and circulate devices within your company. Storage space and size is critical since it not only dictates storage space, but also the performance of the device, which may be hindered due to low storage. This will help you evaluate if you want to move information to OneDrive or erase data to bring devices to an optimal state. You can also view a device's compliance status and take action to move it to a desired state. Now let's look at Anita's device. As soon as Anita enrolled her work profile, the IT administrator is able to view the health of her device and make any required changes. Previously, if you were to find out warranty information of all devices, you'd have to go to Surface Support Service Center. Enter the serial number, enter the CAPTCHA, store information in your own internal database, and then repeat this process for all your devices. Imagine having to do this every quarter when you had a device refresh or there were changes to your warranty. If you had 1,000 devices and each warranty query took a minute, that's 16 hours of your time. Now, all this information is available in one quick view, helping you to plan for device support as well as device refresh. You can also take a look at the type of warranty and coverage in detailed view and know if your device has standard, accidental damage protection, or extended service plan. Surface Management Portal is available for all of our supported Surface devices, including traditional form factors, such as Surface Laptop, Book, Go, Pro, Laptop Studio, and Surface Laptop Go, along with ARM-based Surface Pro X, Surface Hubs with Teams OS, Windows OS, and Surface Duo with Android OS. We are just setting up the foundation of seamless IT experiences with Surface Management Portal. We will continue investing in this area to bring advanced capability in every launch cycle. Thank you so much for joining us today, and don't forget to check out the Surface Management Portal in the All Services section of your Microsoft Endpoint Manager. We can't wait for you to explore this new capability. We hope you like using it as much as we loved building it. Stay safe, stay healthy. Thank you.